गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे आई स्टार्ट विथ एन एग्जाम्पल हाउ टू फाइंड द प्राइस इंडेक्स नंबर्स बाई डिफरेंट मेथड्स और डिफरेंट फार्मूला विच आर लैस्पर्स फार्मूला, पास्टिस फार्मूला, फिशर्स आइडियल इंडेक्स नंबर, मार्शल एवर ग्रोथ फार्मूला. ओके, सो एज एन एग्जाम्पल लेट्स से दिस एग्जाम्पल. Construct all the index numbers of the given data. Okay, given data taking as the base here and others are given. Okay, the question is this form. The commodity is given, A, B, C are the product. Now in 1960, in the year 1960, the prices are, there are two column, price and quantity. Prices are given as 8, 10, 7, price per unit, and quantity is given as 6, 5, 8. So this is the price and quantity in the year 1960. And this is the price and quantity in the year 1968. Which are 12, 11, 8, 5, 6, 5. Okay? So, from this data, we have to find the index numbers from the different formulas. Okay? So, we will start with this table. First commodity, which are given as A, B, and C. Second, now P0, so this is the base year. Okay, it is given as the base year 1960. So in the base year, the prices denoted as P0 and quantity denoted as Q0. So P0 are 8, 10, 7, quantity 6, 5, 8. And prices in the current year are given as P1 and Q1. So P1, 12, 11, 8, 5, 6, 5. Now, to find the Lasper's index number, the formula to find the Lasper's index number was Lasper's index I01 equals to, what is the formula? Summation P1Q0 divided by summation P0Q0, okay, into 100. So we need to find P1Q0, P0Q0. So P1Q0, P0Q0. Okay, now to find the Pastis index number, Pastis index, which is I01, what is the formula? Summation P1Q1 divided by summation P0Q1 into 100. Okay, so we need to find P1Q1 and we need to find P0Q1. Okay, now P1Q0, so P1Q0, 12 into 6, 72, 11 into 5, 55, 8 into 8, 64. P0Q0, 8 into 6, 48, 10 into 5, 50, 7 into 8, 56. Next, P1Q1, 12 into 5, 60, 66, 8 into 5, 40. Next, P0Q1, 8 into 5, 40, 10 into 5, 60, 7 into 8, 56. Okay, now adding up to, you can use the calculator to add this part. So summation P1Q0 will be 191, P0Q0 154, P1Q1 126, 166. Okay, and P0Q1 156. So this will be 7 into 5, 35, sorry. This will be 7 into 5. P1Q1. Sorry, P0Q1. This is 40, okay, correct. P0Q1. This is P0Q1. P0Q1. 35, sorry. This is 35. Okay. So, 135. Okay. Now, putting all this value in this equation, summation P1Q0, summation P1Q0, this is 191 divided by summation P0Q0, 154 into 100. Now, calculating, we'll get 124. Okay. Next, 124 point something. Also, this is P1Q1 by P0Q0. P1Q1 means 166 divided by P0Q1, 135. This is 135, okay, into 100. It will be 123 point something. Okay, I just write 124, 123. Now, Fisher's index number. Fisher's index number is I01 equals to, now Fisher's index number is the geometric mean of these two number, which what is geometric mean? Root under of these two value multiplied, okay, 124 into 123 into 100, okay, it will be something 123.499 equals to 123. We can write right up to one decimal, we will find 123.5. So this is the Fisher's index number. Okay. So, and you can also find the Ashworth index. I01 equals to summation P0 into Q0 plus Q1 divided by summation P1 into Q0, sorry, P1 into Q0 plus Q1 and P0 into Q0 plus Q1, okay, into 100. So this is the formula for Marshall-Evergoth Ashworth index number, right? Let me check this more time. Okay, now if we expand this, we will get summation P1Q0 plus summation P1Q1 divided by summation P0Q0 plus summation P0Q1 into 100. Now we all know these values are given in this part. Okay, summation P1Q0, which is 191, plus summation P1Q1, which is 166, divided by summation P0Q0, which is 154, plus summation P0Q1, which is 135, into 100. Now calculating, we will get something, some numbers, which will be the Marshall-Ashworth index number. Okay, so in this way, from any table, we can find the all the index numbers. Okay, now, next part, I have also given the note, you can check it out, okay, from the given note. Now, next, quantity index number, okay. Next is quantity index number. So, previous index numbers are all the price index number. Next is quantity index number. Quantity index number. Generally, we'll denote the quantity index number in this form Q01. Okay, so price index numbers are in the form I01 and this will be Q01. Now, when we find the price index number, you can easily check that the ratios are between the prices P1 by P0. okay, in this form, summation P1 by P0, if there is a weight, so summation P1W divided by summation P0W. And when we change the weight by their quantity in the base years or in the price years, current year, we get the different formula, less pass, pass cheese, fissures, okay. Here similar, but here we take the ratio between their quantities, okay. So quantity index number, the formulas are, one, first simple aggregate index number. So for simple index number, the formula is summation Q1 by summation Q0 into 100. Okay. Now if there is a price between them or there is a weight between them, okay, if there is a weight between the their quantity, we will get weighted index number. Okay, weighted index number is in this form, Q1W summation Q0W into 100. Okay. Next, third, if we change this weight by their prices in the base year or current year, we will get the different formulas as less pass, less pass index, which is given by, now less in less pass index, we will replace this weight by the price in the base year. So we will get Q1 P0 divided by summation Q0 P0 into 100. Fourth, pass cheese index, which is, now in this part we replace the weight by the price in the current year. So Q1 P1 divided by summation Q0 P1 into 100. Similar way for the fissures index. Fissures index is the geometric mean of these two index, less pass and pass cheese. So we will get Q1 P0 divided by summation Q0 P0 into summation Q1 P1 divided by summation Q0 P1 into 100. 100 is not under the root, okay, because root under into 100 into 100, that means 100 square, so 100 will be taken out from the root, okay. Similar way, Marshall-Ashworth formula is Marshall-Ashworth index, is when we replace the weight by the average of the two prices in the base year and current year. So we will get summation Q1 into P0 plus P1 divided by summation Q0 into P0 plus P1 into 100. When you take the average by 2 will be cancelled out. So after we will get this formula. Okay. So these are the all in the quantity index number. This is all similar as the price index number. Okay, so we can find the index number from a given table by when it is asked to find the quantity index number. Okay. Now there is two tests are there. One is time reversal test. And second is factor reversal test. What is time reversal test? Time reversal test is on the price index number. So price index number, when some formula or some index number follows, satisfies the time reversal test, then this formula will be called ideal index number. Okay. So time reversal test is if I01 into I10. That is, whenever we find a price index number I01, if we just replace 0, interchanging 0 and 1, that is base year as the current year as the base year. So we will get the index number I10. If it is given as 1, then we can say that the above formula is satisfied by the time reversal test. Okay. If not, then if I01 into I10 does not equals to 1, then it is not satisfy the time reversal test. Okay. So, and the factor reversal test is based on the quantity index number. Okay. So quantity index number Q01 into capital P01. So Q01 is when we taken the quantity in the base year and current year. Okay. And P01 when we replace P and Q. Okay, quantity and price. Replace the quantity and price in the quantity index number, we will get P01. If it is given as P1Q1 by P0Q0. If it is given that the P1Q1 equals to P0Q0. Okay. So we can say that the above formula is satisfied by the factor reversal test. If not, then the formula is not satisfied by the factor reversal test. Okay. So just remember, there are three formula for these three formula, and others is Marshall for this four formula. For this four formula, Laspers and Pastis does not satisfy the time reversal test. Only Fisher's and Marshall Ashworth formula satisfies the time reversal test. Okay. The quantity index number. Okay. Just say. For time reversal test, price index number of Laspers and Pastis does not satisfy, but Fisher's and Marshall Ashworth formula satisfies the time reversal test. Time reversal test. Okay, just remember, it can be used as the MCQ question. Okay, and for quantity index number, Laspers quantity index number and Pastis quantity index number. Laspers and Pastis and Marshall Ashworth formula, Marshall in quantity index, set does not satisfy. That factor reversal test. Fisher's in quantity index satisfies the factor reversal test. Okay, so if there is a question, which one of the index number is satisfies by the both test, time reversal test and factor reversal test, which is Fisher's quantity index number and Fisher's price index number. So Fisher's price index number satisfies both the factor reversal test and time reversal test. Okay, and which one of the index number of the above index number satisfies the time reversal test but does not satisfy the factor reversal test? So that will be the Marshall-Ezworth index number. Okay, so Marshall-Ezworth price index number satisfies time reversal test, but Marshall-Ezworth quantity index number does not satisfy the factor reversal test. Okay, so I will be giving some question or note, just go through with it. In the next class I will start with the cost of living index. Okay, okay, so that's it for today. Okay, thank you.